When I was working on my seasonal cookbook, I felt that chocolate is so beautiful, so delicious, that it deserved its own season. Therefore, my cookbook has 5 seasons. The 5th season, chocolate. My name is Nathan Lyon. I'm an Emmy-nominated chef, cookbook author, and I live in Austin, Texas. Today, I am making my favorite cookie recipe. It has chocolate, has oats, roasted pecans, has brown butter, some orange zest. It took me over 3 years to develop this recipe, but I never quite nailed the title. It's a little bit too long, so I just like to call it the cookie. The first and probably most important step in making these incredible cookies is to taste the chocolate. Now, I've chose 60.5% dark chocolate. It has this really lovely, deep, well-rounded chocolate flavor, this sort of nice sheen of vanilla, and the end is this beautiful surge of caramel, and it melts beautifully. There. So good. So good. When I think about a really good cookie, some of the flavors that come to mind are like nuttiness, butteriness, and toffee. And that is easily achieved by browning butter. So behind me in a small saute pan, I have some butter that I'm browning over medium heat. And I'm adding a bit of coconut oil. The foundation for any cookie is a little bit of all-purpose flour, some kosher salt, and some baking soda. That all goes in. Let's move to the sweetness, shall we? I have granulated sugar. To that, I'm going to whisk in 2 whole large eggs, in addition to some vanilla extract. The chocolate has that vanilla flavor, but you also want to season the cookie itself. And 2 tablespoons of water, cold water. Give this a nice whisk until all of the sugar is in solution. Now's a good time actually to add that brown butter and melted coconut oil. I'm just gonna whisk it as I drizzle it in. Next step, dark brown sugar and orange zest. And the reason why I'm adding the brown sugar now and not at the beginning with the granulated sugar is I don't want the brown sugar to dissolve in solution, because as the cookie bakes, it actually caramelizes the brown sugar and gives a wonderful texture to the finished cookie. And with orange zest, nothing is better flavor-wise than fresh orange zest. Now we'll move on to the dry ingredients. When you add the dry ingredients, don't whisk like crazy. Be gentle with it. Fold it in with your spatula. You don't want to develop so much gluten in the flour that it becomes tough, but just enough to incorporate it. And then we move on to the yummy parts. All right, now it wouldn't be my favorite cookie without my favorite nut. So I have some roasted, lightly salted pecans. The cool thing is, when my girlfriend and I moved here to Austin, Texas about 2 years ago, we happened to move into a neighborhood where about half of the trees are pecan trees. So imagine this, I'm running up on people's lawns, harvesting fresh pecans. To be honest, they're the most delicious, freshest pecans I've ever had. So I crack them open, put them on a sheet tray in the oven at 350 for about 10 to 15 minutes until they're lightly brown, and then give them a rough chop. Delicious. Next up is rolled oats. Enter the star of the show, the chocolate. And what I've done is I've taken these chocolate pieces and I've chopped them really well with a serrated knife. Now what that does is you get this wonderful texture. The tiny little pieces actually go and melt into the cookie itself, and the larger pieces give you these wonderful pools of melted chocolate. And using a serrated knife actually holds onto the chocolate as you're chopping it, so the pieces don't fly off the cutting board. You need some elbow grease. Really stir this well so that every single bite of every single cookie has everything you want. You know, one of the things I've learned over the years as a chef is when you start with really great products, your finished product is really, really delicious. And that's why I've been using Cho for over 10 years, because I think it's the best. And then you learn later on, you peel back the layers, that their special sauce is their really wonderful relationship that they have with the farmers, because they empower them with the tools they need to put out the best product possible. There we go. That looks great. I'm gonna wrap this up, put it in the fridge for at least 24 hours and up to 3 days. I woke up so excited this morning because we finally get to bake off these delicious cookies. I'm rolling the dough into equal sized balls and really compact them, because once they hit the heat of the oven, they'll want to spread, and that's okay. But when they're in a shape like this, they spread right and they start to set at the right time, getting a nice crisp edge and a nice chewy center.
Yes, yes, yes.
This is exactly what I'm looking for. You have this darker brown edge, which will end up being crispy, along this golden brown, which is in the top, but then the top looks a little soft, which is great because it'll translate into a gooey center, but you don't want to leave them on the sheet pan because you have this residual heat that will continue cooking the cookie. So I'll pull them off. Now is the moment of truth. Grab a nice, still slightly warm cookie and take a look inside. Oh, yes. I am never bored with this cookie. Texture-wise, it's crispy from edge to edge. You get that gooey center, but as they say, the proof is in the taste. Every time a smile, it never fails because the freshly roasted pecans, you have the bright vibrancy of that orange zest. And of course, you want to swim around in those melted pools of Choe chocolate. This cookie, the cookie, was 3 years in the making and it's totally worth the wait. Cheers.